Hey guys, Janik here for Cinecom.net and welcome back to the best YouTube show in the whole wide world. And today we are going to show you how you can go viral on Instagram with some awesome special effects. And the best thing about it all is that they are quite simple to make. So without wasting time, let's jump into it. The first effect is this egg puking loop from Alex Ezorsky. We first wanted to show you how you can do his famous mirror dive, but he already did an awesome tutorial about that, link in the description. So we decided to do another loop effect from him, hence the egg puking. Now, what do you need? A tripod, a camera on that tripod, and an actor in front of it. Now shove a ball-like object in his mouth, and no, don't do anything funny. For the framing, you can give your actor enough headspace and room next to him. We can always crop in the post-production. Then we are ready to press record. Let your actor stand still, and with the ball in his mouth, he can start with looking down. Then he can look up, act surprised, and again look down and drop the ball gently. Then he needs to look back up again and try to match his position for the beginning. And that's it. Now let's twirl into Premiere Pro. Place your shot in the timeline and you can already duplicate it. Set the opacity of the duplicate to 50% and drag the duplicate to the right. Here we are going to look for the point where the two positions match the best in the part where your actor looks up. Once you have that, select the beginning of both clips by holding the shift and clicking on it. Now trim them to the wanted point and do the exact same for the end of both clips. And this will leave you with two exactly the same clips. Last thing, place them together and add a morph cut to hide the cut a little bit better. Let it analyze and maybe fine-tune the length of the morph cut and the position. Now select everything and nest it. Duplicate the nest and add a flip vertical to it. Now position it so that the two clips become an extended of each other. On the duplicated clip, you can add a reverse time effect and match the timing of the ball. And bada bim, bada boom, it's done.
The second effect is quite easy. We'll be recreating this arm stretching effect right here. Just take a shot of your talent lifting up the bar, but let go of the bar right when he starts to pull. Do make sure to add small tracking points on the arm, as you can see right here. And I recommend to make them as small as possible so you don't have to remove them in post-production. And next to this, we also need an empty shot. Now open up After Effects and drag both clips to your sequence. Make three duplicates of the acting clip and rename them to left arm, right arm, and hands. Look for the point where you start to pull. Make a cut on these three layers, delete everything of these layers before the cut, and freeze frame them. Now mask out the hands and the arms of each respective layer. After this, select your acting clip. Go to the tracking panel and choose track motion. Put your tracking marker above our tracking point and let it do its job. When the tracking is finished, create a null and apply your tracking data to it. Do this also for the other arm as well. And now it's time to make our arm stretch. With your puppet spin tool, add two points on the masked out arm. One on the bottom of the arm and the other one right on the point where your tracking point is. Now open up the property of the puppet pin tool and of the tracking data. Parent your pin that is on top of the arm to the position of the null. Do this for both arms. Precomp each arm again together with its null layer and clean up the edges on top of the arm with some mask so it blends perfect with the original arm. As you can see, both arms will now stretch. Of course, you can still see the original arm behind it. Just select your acting clip and mask away these parts where you can see this. And when that is done, you finally have your stretching arms.
Now for a bonus tip. Do you know our cool Roto Dance transition video? Well, you can too easily create such a video. And hear me out, guys. The bonus tip is Storyblocks video, of course. Most of the cool assets we used in the dance video came from Storyblocks video. So like you can see, Storyblocks video can help you with all your video projects, even with going viral on social media. But besides all those cool video assets, they also have a buttload of title animations, which are also super handy for your socials. Now, of course, once you have Storyblocks video, why not download everything? Like stock clips, After Effects templates, overlays, everything. Because for only one single price per year, you can download an unlimited amount of video assets. So to start downloading, go to the first link in the description below. Lorenzo, take it away for the last effect.
The last effect is going to be this floating ball in the sky. Now, what do we need? Well, that's easy, only two shots. One shot where you and a friend are playing with a ball and suddenly that ball goes too high up in the sky. And a second shot of a ball falling in water. Now bring these two shots inside After Effects and place the actor shot on the bottom and the water shot on top. The first thing we need to do is remove the ball of the actor shot when it goes too high up. You can do this with an empty shot or using different parts of the current sky. Once done, match the ball of the extra clip with the ball of the water clip. You obviously need to flip the water clip. Then, let's single out the ball in the water clip, draw a detailed mask around it, and of course, track the mask. Now, the only thing we need to do is the displacement in the sky. Duplicate the water clip and remove the mask around the ball. Take the tint effect and add that to the duplicate. This will make it black and white. Then also add the curves effect and create an S-curve until you have a better contrast in the whites and blacks. Then, pre-comp the duplicate water clip and look for the displacement map effect. This effect you can add to the actual clip, and within that setting you can set the displacement map layer to the pre-combed water layer. Then set the horizontal and vertical displacement options to luminance and display them both. And that's it!
Time for Genix Fun Fact Fountain! All the way back in 2013, Instagram released a 15-second video component to its platform, and this was to compete with Twitter's Vine. Within the first 24 hours, 5 million videos were uploaded. And now, each day, 500 million Instagram stories are posted. And Vine is dead. So yeah, that's a big power move from Instagram. And that was it for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Storyblocks Video, for the support. And like always, stay creative. Guys, did you notice something in the background? No? Well, that box right here. In the beginning of my studio, that box isn't there. In Lorenzo's studio, the box is there. And now it's also there. What happened? Well, the box fell and Jordi repaired it. Real stuff happens here at Cinecom.